Friends, today our topic is cuboidal fossa. This is the diagram of the cuboidal fossa. This is the triangular hollow shape fossa which is located in front of the elbow joint. See, this is the triangle hollow space which is seen just in front of the elbow joint. If you see the boundaries of the cuboidal fossa, the base, first one is base, apex, lateral boundary, medial boundary. This is the right hand diagram. Okay, this is the lateral side and this is the medial side. Now we'll see the boundaries. See here, this is the base. Actually, the cuboidal fossa is this part. Okay, this is the base which is formed by joining the epicondyles. This is the lateral epicondyle and this is the medial epicondyle. So this forms the base. And look here, this is the medial boundary. This medial boundary is formed by the pronator teres. This is the pronator teres muscle. This pronator teres is having medial margin and the lateral margin. Here the lateral margin of the pronator teres will forms the medial boundary of the cuboidal fossa. And look here, this is the brachioradialis muscle and this is the extensor carpi radialis longus. And the lateral boundary is formed by the medial margin of the brachioradialis. Okay, this is the brachioradialis muscle. Its medial margin will forms the lateral boundary of the cuboidal fossa. Okay, next, apex. This apex is formed by the convergence of these two muscles. And this is the base. Base, apex, medial boundary and the lateral boundary. And roof. If you see the roof is formed by the skin, superficial fascia having the median cuboidal wing along with the median and lateral cutaneous nerve of forearm. This is the lateral cutaneous nerve of forearm and this is the median cutaneous nerve of forearm and this is the median cuboidal wing which is seen in the superficial fascia. After reflecting the skin, we will see the superficial fascia with these contents. After superficial fascia, we will see the deep fascia and then this deep fascia is somewhat, it was thick on its medial side by the presence of the bicipital aponeurosis. This forms the roof. See, this is the brachialis muscle. This is the pronator teres. This is the brachioradialis. Here, the floor is formed by the upper and medial part, the floor is formed by the brachialis muscle, whereas the lower and lateral part, the floor is formed by the supinator muscle. This is the supinator muscle. This completes the boundaries. If you see the contents of the cuboidal fossa, from medial to lateral, the first one is, this one is the median nerve. This is the median nerve. And this is the brachial artery and after that bicipital tendon. See here, this is the bicipital tendon and see the radial nerve. We can remember with a mnemonic known as MBBR. From medial to lateral, median nerve, brachial artery, bicipital tendon and radial nerve. So first we have to know about the median nerve. Look here, this is the median nerve which passes downwards vertically and then it enters between the two heads of the pronator teres. See here, this is the pronator teres muscle this is the humeral head, and here this is the ulnar head. This is the radius bone and this is the ulna bone. This is the ulnar head and this is the humeral head. This is the pronator teres muscle. This median nerve, it descends vertically, it passes downwards vertically between the two heads of the pronator teres, humeral head and ulnar head. Before passing between the two heads of the pronator teres, it gives a branch to the pronator teres muscle just at the level above the elbow. And then it passes downwards and it reaches the flexor compartment of forearm. That is about the median nerve. Next we will see the brachial artery. This brachial artery, almost it lies center of the cuboidal fossa, just medial to the biceps brachii muscle. Okay, this is the brachial artery. This brachial artery, exactly at the level of the neck of the radius, it bifurcates into, this is the radial artery and this is the ulnar artery. This is the ulnar artery and this is the artery. This is the radial artery. Now first we will see about the radial artery. This radial artery, it passes downwards and laterally and it rests upon the bicipital tendon, supinator muscle. Look here, this is the supinator muscle and brachioradialis muscle. This is the brachioradialis muscle and this is the supinator muscle and this is the bicipital tendon. While passing downwards and laterally, it rests upon these three structures. One is the bicipital tendon, supinator muscle and the brachioradialis muscle. And it gives a branch which passes upwards, that is known as a radial recurrent artery. This is known as the radial recurrent artery. This radial recurrent artery, it passes, while it ascends up, it passes between the, see here, this is the radial nerve. This radial nerve, at in front of the lateral epicondyle, it divides into superficial branch and the deep branch. So this radial recurrent artery will passes between the superficial branch and the deep branch. This is the deep branch and this is the superficial branch. It passes just between these two structures and makes an anastomosis with the ascending branch of the profunda brachii artery. As we all know, in elbow joint anastomosis, we will see the anastomosis in front of the lateral epicondyle, which is formed by this radial recurrent artery and from above anterior descending branch of the profunda brachii artery, which is the intern branch coming from the brachial artery. This profunda brachii artery is a branch of brachial artery. So here this radial recurrent artery will make an anastomosis with the anterior descending branch of the profunda brachii artery. Okay, and then this radial artery, after giving up the branch, then it leaves this cuboidal fossa from through the apex point. Okay, this is the continuation of the radial artery. That is about the radial artery. Next we will see about the ulnar artery. This is the ulnar artery, which is the largest terminal branch. This ulnar artery, within the cuboidal fossa, it gives three branches. One is the anterior ulnar recurrent, posterior ulnar recurrent and common interosseous recurrent. Ulnar artery branches are anterior ulnar recurrent, posterior ulnar recurrent and common interosseous recurrent. If you see this anterior ulnar recurrent artery, anterior ulnar recurrent artery will make an anastomosis with the inferior ulnar collateral artery, which is the branch of brachial artery. If you see the branches of the brachial artery, it gives superior ulnar collateral, inferior ulnar collateral, profunda brachial artery, muscular branches, and nutrient artery. So it gives up, these are the branches of brachial artery, nutrient artery, muscular branches, to all biceps muscle, coracobrachialis, brachialis muscle. These are the muscular branches. And then it gives a superior ulnar collateral, inferior ulnar collateral, and a profunda brachial artery. And the terminal branches are radial artery and ulnar artery. Now, this anterior ulnar recurrent artery, which is the branch coming from the ulnar artery. Look here, this is the ulnar artery. This ulnar artery will give the anterior ulnar recurrent artery. This anterior ulnar recurrent artery will make an anastomosis with the inferior ulnar collateral artery coming from above, which is the branch of brachial artery. Okay, that is, that anastomosis is seen in front of the medial epicondyle. Next, if you see the posterior ulnar recurrent artery, this posterior ulnar recurrent artery will make an anastomosis with the superior ulnar collateral artery from the above behind the medial epicondyle. This is about the posterior ulnar recurrent artery. And what about this common interosseous artery? This common interosseous artery between the radius and ulna bone, we will see the interosseous membrane. At the superior margin of this interosseous membrane, this common interosseous artery will give the branches anterior interosseous artery and the posterior interosseous artery, which passes behind the interosseous membrane. This is about the ulnar artery branches. And then after giving these branches, and it passes behind the beneath the ulnar head of the pronator-teres muscle. Look here, this is the ulnar head and this is the humeral head. This ulnar artery will passes beneath the ulnar head of the pronator-teres. By this, this median nerve and artery is separated by the ulnar head of the pronator-teres muscle. As we all know that median nerve is passing between the two heads, humeral head and ulnar head of the pronator teres muscle. So beneath the deep head of the pronator teres, we will see the ulnar artery. Okay. This is about the brachial artery. Next, we will see the biceps brachii muscle, which passes downwards and laterally. It inserts at the posterior rough part of the radial tuberosity. The insertion of this tendon is posterior rough part of the radial tuberosity, and the anterior rough part of the radial tuberosity is separated by a bursa. A bursa is there on the anterior part of the tuberosity, whereas the posterior part of the tuberosity, simply this tendon of this biceps brachii is inserted in a twisted manner. Okay. Before inserting into the tuberosity, from its medial margin, it gives a small extension towards the medial side. That is known as the bicipital aponeurosis. This is the bicipital aponeurosis. Next, we completed median nerve, brachial artery, and the bicipital tendon. And the fourth one is the radial nerve. This is the radial nerve. This radial nerve we see in the cuboidal fossa at its superolateral angle. At the superolateral angle, after coming from the radial groove, it just winds around the lateral supracondylar ridge and it enters into the cuboidal fossa. Okay, in the cuboidal fossa, we'll see between the brachialis muscle and the brachioradialis muscle. Between these two muscles, we will see at the supralateral angle, we will see the radial nerve. This radial nerve will descends in front of the lateral epicondyle and splits into the superficial branch and the deep branch. Superficial branch will goes like this. This is the superficial branch and this is the deep branch. This deep branch will passes, this is the supinator muscle, will passes between the superficial and deep strata of the supinator muscle and it enters into the extensor compartment. Okay, before piercing the supinator muscle, this radial nerve will gives a branch to the extensor carpi radialis brevis muscle. Extensor carpi radialis brevis muscle branch to the supinator muscle and then it enters into the extensor compartment of the forearm. This is about the radial nerve. So by this we completed the median nerve, brachial artery, bicipital tendon and the radial nerve. This radial nerve having the two branches, superficial branch and the superficial branch which is the cutaneous. It continues as the cutaneous branch by passing underneath the brachioradialis muscle. Okay, deep branch which pierces the supinator muscle and it gives a branch to the supinator and extensor carpi radialis brevis muscle. Okay, this is about the cubital fossa. If you see the clinical aspects of the cubital fossa, this bicipital aponeurosis will form a thin platform for the median cubital vein while during the venae punctures. Apart from that, it also protects the brachial artery and the median nerve. These are the underneath structures of the deep fascia. Okay, thank you.